What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to the Illinois Tech Dynasty. One more video before hopping into Season 4. We've got Part 2 of the Season 3 Offseason. To get things kicked off, I do want to confirm our schedule for this year, the same that I showed last time around. So we're taking on Mid-Tennessee State and Oregon the first 2 weeks on the road. Week 4 at home against Rice. Conference play begins Week 5 against Temple on the road. We got a pretty decent schedule, so B-, I'm not going to complain too much. Just to fly through our roster really quickly, Nate Taylor, Kevin Fields, bit of controversy at quarterback, Brandon Sanchez, TC Jackson, Damon Valeri. Of course, Anthony Bishop at running back, Andre Hafer, Darnell Wolfe, and Greg Reyes, Jay Miller, Justin Mullins at fullback. We have two fullbacks that are pretty good on the roster. Receiving core is looking pretty good this year. Trios Garcia, who probably won't play this year, Shelton O'Brien, we all know we're excited to see him. Edwards, the top tight end, Jason Scott, J.R. Jones, Mike Haynes, and John Miles. Pretty huge upgrade for us at offensive line this year. Pretty much everyone's new, except for Corbett at left tackle. Some guys redshirted, some guys are brand new. That would be Travis Richardson, and of course, Kendall Gardner at left guard. Moving on to the defensive line, Corbin and Jason Hicks. Of course, there's McKenzie and Jamal Foster. Ed right in. Defensive tackles this year, sophomore DeAndre Mackey. JUCO transfer Jamal Walker, Patrick Hawkins, and Andy Smith. Outside linebackers, Hayden Bush, Tiger Anderson, Dan Sellers. Middle linebackers, Ricky Hodges, Jonathan West, Chris Manning, Jarrett Johnson, Brian Gooden. Then a right outside linebacker, there's Curtis Goodman, Kurt Heron, and the freshman, Tremaine Vincent. Cornerbacks this year, this is going to be a pretty interesting year because people will be moving around. I don't know how we're going to set this up to kick off the year. We'll go over that a little bit in the next couple of minutes. Safety is looking pretty good. Victor Hicks, Joe Washington, Quincy Russell, and then, of course, Jack Cobbs, Noah Harrell, and the freshman, Mike Smith. Sophomore kicker, Zach Carroll, looking for an improved year over last season. And, of course, the redshirt freshman, Corey Perkins, 81 overall. I'm looking very forward to see what he can do this year. So new coaching personnel, pretty much a brand new team. That means a brand new playbook on both sides of the football. And here's a look at the offensive playbook for this season. It's not finalized yet. We're going to be making some tweaks here and there. There are some plays that I've seen in practice that just don't work that I want to take out. We're still going to be primarily a pistol/shotgun offense, and you'll see a lot of that, and you see a lot of formations from last season. But you're also noticing a few new formations, some bunch looks, a lot of more empty sets. We have the receivers to now go empty a lot more often. Still going to try to find a way to get Bishop moved around, maybe line him up slot left, slot right. Edwards will get involved, although he's not the greatest receiver in the world. But one thing that's not going to change is our priority to run the football and run the football well. This offensive line is a huge upgrade, not just in pass blocking, which is huge, but also in run blocking. Bishop's going to have huge lanes to run through. You can see it here. And Bishop, for some reason, I don't know what's going on, but he looks so much faster than last year. And his speed only went up by one. Here's one more look. You'll see a lot this year. The split back look from the shotgun and just hand the ball off to your running back and let him run loose. Didn't see a lot of that last year, mainly because we didn't have the running backs to make that happen. It was Bishop and Bishop only, but Andre Hayford. Redshirt freshman, Parkville, Maryland. He's got the speed, he's got the power, and I really think he's the guy that's going to replace Bishop. This is his senior year. There's a lot in store for this run game this year. And I don't want to take snaps away from Bishop, but Andre Hafer is going to have to get the football because he looks pretty lethal. Here's a nice screen play from the split back look. Just so many things we can do from this formation. Here's a nice screen out to Torrios. He's also in for a pretty big season, his junior season. Almost broke 1,000 yards this year, but let's not forget about the big threat down the field, Marcus O'Brien. I am so excited to finally let him see the field during the season. Taking a look at Nate Taylor, and this is one of the big reasons why we might not play Nate Taylor this season, at least to start, or at least in certain plays. He's definitely not Kevin Fields. He doesn't have that arm that can just rip one down the field and let your receiver go up there and make a play. It's not that strong. Yes, he can make these throws, you know, 15, 20, sometimes 30, 40 yards down the field, but it's just not consistent enough. Nate Taylor is a play creator, likes to use his mobility, make some plays down the field, and that's what he was pretty good at last season. Now, moving on to another recruit that I had really hoped was going to play this year, Mike Haynes, who was an athlete from Pennsylvania. He's 6'7", 234. And one of the big questions about him heading into this year was going to be his run blocking. As you can see there, it wasn't very good. McKenzie got off that block immediately, but he did a pretty good job there locking up a corner. But the big question for him is, how well do you block when we need you to block at the goal line? Right there, gets blown up by Goodman, two plays in a row. Blown up by Goodman. And this was happening quite a bit. But then again, it's not his game. Mike Haynes, he's a big body receiver that I want to play at tight end. You can see him get down the field. He can stretch defenses. I think that's one of the big reasons why I like this kid. He can stretch defenses. He has 94 jumping. Look at this catch in traffic. 6'7", just elite leaping ability. He's great. But then again, he also makes some plays like this. His hands aren't the best in the world. He also drops a football every now and then. So I think we're looking very forward to seeing where this team is this year. But the big question is the defense. And look at the true freshman, Victor Hicks. Recruited him at corner out of Virginia. He wants to play safety, and I'm going to let him play safety. That was a great play. His cover skills are pretty much dominant already. Great one-handed catch there. That foot was not in bounds. But, of course, the big question for this team is our rotation at the secondary. Now, Davis, I think, by far is the best corner on the team. Has a pretty good blend of speed, good man coverage, good zone, and by far has the best press rating on the team. So his job at CB1 or DB1 or cornerback 1 is secure. His backups, however, are not. Joe Washington, I thought about actually moving him to corner. He's pretty good. Good speed. Coverage and press ratings are pretty much on par, but he will play backup safety this year. Now, strong safety is the big question. Jack Cobbs, Noah Harrell, and the freshman Mike Smith from Mississippi, all around the same overall, but if you look at how their ratings kind of merge together, Mike Smith's the better tackler. Jack Cobbs has a higher hit power. Block shedding, they're all around the same, but that goes to Mike Smith. Man coverage, that belongs to Noah Harrell, but zone coverage goes to Mike Smith, and press goes to Jack Cobbs. They're all kind of hodgepodge, and I'm a bit worried about having three strong safeties play this year. So Noah Harrell and Jack Cobbs redshirted last year. Cobbs was one of our season one recruits. He played during season two, then I redshirted him during this past year because he just had to improve in coverage. And he did. He went up quite a bit in coverage. Noah Harrell was a recruit from last season, came in as a JUCO sophomore redshirt, and now he's playing out his sophomore year with us. So one thing you are seeing, these past couple plays, our corners, while they are going to give up plays every now and then, out routes are still going to be an issue. One thing I'm really happy to see is good coverage on the outside by Jamal Dwyer. He was getting beat. He was the number one person getting beat last year in press coverage. And I'm just continually testing him. And another great play on the ball. And Marcus O'Brien is a great receiver. Good release rating, great route runner. And he's done a great job in this practice so far. But look at Jack Cobbs. There go some points for him. Nice job there in zone coverage. So making some changes at corner. And at number three, redshirt freshman Pete Davis and the true freshman Sean Hollins from Arizona. I really like both of these guys. Sean Hollins, I thought about playing at receiver, and I decided to put him at corner. We're already kind of crowded, and Hollins is not that bad. 6'3 with great speed. You're going to see a nice play in coverage here to knock the ball away. Wish he would have caught the football with his catch rating, but that just didn't happen. They go to a mid-screen here with Marcus O'Brien. Here's where this defense might have problems in the secondary. These guys are not great block shedders. And that's not just at safety, the corners as well. I mean, everyone gets locked up here. I mean, obviously, it's really nice to see the big play potential for Marcus O'Brien, but it's also a bit concerning to see that secondary get beat like that. So testing the secondary with a couple more plays here. This is cover two against four verts. And I want to see how quickly these safeties can close down on these routes. And two back-to-back plays, Jack Cobbs and Victor Hicks doing a great job in this practice so far, but everything isn't great. Victor Hicks gets kind of flat-footed there, and Shelton runs right by him. Kevin Fields again will throw. Look at this completion, or would-be completion, to Marcus O'Brien. Victor Hicks lays the boom. Did a great job crashing down on the football and knocked that ball away. So on to special teams. In comes Zach Carroll. Big sophomore year for him. wasn't the best last year. 77% was a bit worrisome from outside of 40 yards, but here he is knocking down 47-yard field goals. We're going to move this back a little bit. This from 50 yards again, drill the kick. Kick from the same distance, but from the right hash, and Zach Carroll drilled that one as well. The special teams unit is looking really good this year. But of course, the untested redshirt freshman Corey Perkins, how was he this year? Not bad. That punt going from around our 20-yard line to the opposing team's 20. So that's a pretty strong leg there. Another kick from him. This one, again, not as deep. That was a little higher punt. Tried to sky that one. But how is the kick coverage this year? We've got Mac Orton and Pete Davis out there. This might be the group I go with for this year. And Anthony Bishop will handle returns this season for the Wolfpack. And I am a bit concerned about the kick coverage. Still obviously a work in progress. Got to keep that net return down. But taking a look at the red shirts for this year, this would have been a little longer of a video, but I decided to keep some plays out. I did show off Brandon Sanchez a bit. His arm, 95 throw power is phenomenal, but we'll probably save that for a later day. Also going to redshirt TC Jackson and Greg Reyes. Two receivers being redshirted this year, Mike Austin and Chris King. I am really excited to see where these guys progress to next season. Mike Austin, definitely a possession receiver. I think Chris King needs to work on his base hands, but both of them are exceptional route runners and very good leapers. We're going to go with two active tight ends this year because we have two fullbacks, so Jay Miller will probably move to tight end three when needed. Or maybe we'll move Justin Mullins because he was recruited to play tight end, or he was recruited as a tight end, but we moved him to fullback. And obviously, we talked about Mike Haynes, 60 pass block, 64 run. Hopefully, that's a little higher next season. Nick Matthews will redshirt this year at left tackle. Andrew Hayes at center from Minnesota will also redshirt this season. And moving on to the defense, JUCO transfer Jamal Walker. As much as it pains me to redshirt an 85 speed defensive tackle, I got to do it. Chris Manning also being redshirted this year. I really, really like Chris Manning as far as a tackler goes. If we were still playing in a 3-4 defense, I would love him. But his coverage ratings are just not reliable. Definitely going to have some packages for him next season, but not this year. Tremaine Vincent also being redshirted this year. He has 89 block shed. I really like Tremaine Vincent, but he needs to redshirt this season. Sean Hollins and Javon Bracken will redshirt this season. It pains me to redshirt Javon Bracken because I really like him. He's a bit slow. I want to get that speed a little higher, but his coverage ratings and his press rating, pretty good. In-state safety Quincy Russell also redshirting this season. I am really lost on where he's going to play next year. Might be a special teamer because honestly, with Victor Hicks and Joe Washington, I don't really see a space for him. And obviously, the door is wide open for Mike Smith, depending on how this year goes for Jack Cobbs and Noah Harrell. So moving on to subscriber recruiting, the five guys that made it. Abraham Charles, defensive tackle, San Diego, the number two DT this year. Trenton Seibold from Warsaw, Indiana, number eight tight end this year. Moving on to receiver Justin Graydon from Houston, Texas, number 51 receiver this year. And then we've got Luke Dawn, halfback from Athens, Ohio, pipeline state for us. Not actively on his board, but that can always change. And the last spot will go to Jacoby Rush of Detroit, Michigan, tight end, number 24 in this recruiting class. So let's get ready to hop into a brand new season of Illinois Tech football. Season 4 is officially open for business. On the road at number 21, Mid-Tennessee State, the Blue Raiders. Can we come away with a huge win against one of the top teams that almost went to a national championship last year? Of course, without their starting quarterback, without their starting receiver from last year, but still pretty difficult team. Taking a look at the American Conference standings, South Florida and Cincinnati are top two teams. There goes Army, the newcomers this year. Here's a look at the Bearcats schedule. We are not playing them this year. They have Nevada to get things going. They have Texas, and they also have Clemson. But their in-conference schedule is looking pretty decent. Here's a look at the American Conference Western Division. Houston and SMU, the only two teams ranked in the Western Division. Here's a look at the preseason polls. Your national championship winners from last year. UCLA, the number one team to get things going. Penn State at 5. Oklahoma State at 10. Georgia Tech, Houston, South Florida, SMU, Bama at 17. Mid-Tennessee State, Bearcats at 22. Illinois Tech not in the top 30 Oregon, Louisville, Clemson, South Carolina, Texas A&M, Stanford 35, Boston College, there's Cal at 37. We play them later this season. 41 Rice, 42 Notre Dame, and 43 Illinois Tech. Here's a look at your All-Americans this season. Finally, some recognition for one of the best running backs in the country, Anthony Bishop, finally getting some shine on the All-NCAA first team. Like I said before, huge year for him. Has not won an award, has not finished on an awards list throughout the past 3 years, and obviously has deserved it, except for All-Americans. He's been on here a couple of times, but really want at least, you know, a Walker Award for him at the end of the year, or at least finish in the top two. Here's a look at the All-American Conference All-Americans. Anthony Bishop, of course, your first halfback. Joshua Holloman at number two. Chris Barr of South Florida. There goes Eric Chirios. Thomas Corbin makes All-American first team. DeAndre Mackey makes first team. Pretty diverse group here. We've got some corners. There goes Jamal Dwyer, Illinois Tech. Joe Washington, surprisingly, making All-American first team at safety, where he was a backup last year. Pretty interesting. Was there no other safeties better than him in the conference? All-American second team, Elijah Mack, third halfback one. Got a couple of guys here from Temple, Southern Methodist. There's David Davis, big year for him. Zach Carroll makes kicker. And then taking a look at the four-year outlook for championship contenders. I'm going to have a really hard time keeping this freshman class from leaving after their junior years to go pro. This is going to be a really, really, really good group of guys that grow together. Definitely going to see some BCS bowl games from these guys, maybe even a national championship. Toughest places to play, Illinois Tech, Soldier Field, number six on the list, a 17 home win streak that was almost ruined by Notre Dame last season. That was a great game. Mid Tennessee State is projected to win this game according to Kirk Herbstreit. The Blue Raiders had a top offense last year, very good defense, but can their defense contain the number one player on this year's preseason Heisman watch list? Finally, even if it's just for the preseason, he's on the list. That is all I'm asking for. That, guys, is it for the offseason part two video. Season four kicking off hopefully next week, maybe 2 weeks from now. Got to go through a couple more things with the playbook, and after that, we should hopefully be good to go. But thank you all for tuning in. Hope you guys enjoyed. Catch you next time. Have a nice day. Season four. Let's do this. Go Wolfpack.